of innovation and striving excellence. So RBA means so retainment, betterment, and attainment of breakthrough. So basic principles from TKM. So it is our organization. So let me start our today content. Human error prevention. So it is our today topic. Most interesting topic, and it is applicable to everywhere, not only for manufacturing or not only for process industry or service sector, colleges, education sector, health sector, everywhere it is applicable. So wherever human is involved, okay, that areas we can able to apply this concept. It is a very fundamental concept to improve that how we can able to avoid that mistakes. Okay, so these are the content of a human error prevention. So what is the error proofing? What is the principles of error proofing? What are the three steps for error proofing? Human error prevention checklist, exercise. If there is a time permit, we can do exercise also. So this is the definitions. So why, what is the human error prevention? So wherever a human working, we cannot able to expect like machine. So machines once programmed from morning to evening, full time, it works as per the same RPM, as per whatever we are given the spec, it will work. Whatever that program we given accordingly, it will work. But human is not like that. Human is not like machines. Human can able to think. So his human mood can change to any extent, positive side or negative side. Human get tired, and human get hungry. So morning, how he work, the same way he cannot able to work at that before lunchtime. So after having heavy meals, he cannot able to work after lunch the same manner how he work in the morning. So it will change. So we cannot able to compare human and machines. So human can able to do the mistakes. Many of us still, whoever the experienced operators we are thinking, or experienced consultant we are thinking, day to day, we are doing mistakes. Okay, so how we are going to prevent this? How we are going to make some system can able to reduce its impact, can able to reduce that errors? So for that only this concept we are going to apply. The objective is to eliminate the defects arising due to human errors. It's not this concept is not applicable to, it is because of machine, this because of method, or because of material, or because of mother nature. So out of 6M, it more focusing on man, due to man. Okay, so goals is to adapt the workstation and its conditions to work. So workers, how we are going to create a better workstations so a human can able to work without errors. So increase the performance of the workers and preserve the health of the workers, to focusing on ergonomics issue also, to reduce the work constraints, to meet the quality requirement of the customer. So what is the error, or what is the mistake proofing? Mistake proofing is a quality assurance technique which aims to eliminate the defects. Okay, so whether it is a manufacturing or service, wherever we are doing mistake, how we are going to eliminate this mistake? Okay, this is what three common misunderstanding we have. Attentiveness can prevent the errors. So focus. Daily the supervisor come to the shop floor and he tell to the employees, oh, more attention, focus the work. Like this, if you give the words and if you're giving more attention, it is not going to prevent the errors. Okay, and education and training can prevent the errors. If somebody's done the mistake, immediately they give training for 1 week. Then after that, if you send, then the same person can able to do mistake in later part. So education and training cannot prevent the errors. Then multi-fold inspection can prevent the errors. So normally in final inspection area, if some of the parts are missed and it went to the customer, any defect part went to the customer, immediately what we can able to do, oh, something happened, we'll add more inspectors. If we add more inspectors, what will happen? We are thinking that the error will reduce. No, we are going to catch the defects only, but still the error is going to start. Still the defects we are not going to attack. Okay, these are the common three misunderstandings we have. Okay, first of all, this concept of human error prevention, we learned from Professor Takeshi Nakasho. Professor Takeshi Nakasho from Cho University, Japan. He is the person got the individual Deming Award category. Okay, he got the Deming Award for his contribution towards quality. Okay, so we learned from him when I was working in the part of MIQ, Mahindra Institute of Quality. Okay, so he introduced this concept towards safety. Okay, how we are going to avoid the human errors towards in a safety angle. So when we learned from him, we thought how we are going to implement this towards the automotive sector to reduce the quality defects. Okay, so based on his study, this is a study report. Based on his study, there is a different mode of consciousness. Okay, and there is a error rate. Let's see, there is a different consciousness. So the person in sleepy mode, 100% there is error chance. The person is tired, okay, then there is a 0.1 rate of error, equal to 10%. The person very good, okay, he is in normal and relaxed mode, okay, he is take the proper rest and routine work, whatever he is doing routine work, the same work he is doing, but still there is a chance of error. The person is very normal and very clear, very active person, but still there is a chance of error rate. Maybe less, but still there is a chance of error rate. The person is more excited, okay, overconfident, okay, panic, okay, but still he can able to do the mistakes, errors. So error occurrence rates always there is. It is based on the study from Professor Takeshi Nakasho. Okay, he given one guideline. Okay, so let me see this. Already we seen that three misunderstanding. The first one is attentiveness. We see the table. Even attentiveness cannot able to prevent the errors. The second one is training. How training can able to prevent the error? Let's see. One company have the standard operating procedure for everything. Okay. Let the first question come. Did the operator or officer he understand the SOP properly? Okay, the question is giving answer is no, then we need to educate them. Sir, in my company everybody understand the SOP, still there is a error chance. Now we come to another question. So did he or she have the skills in the following SOP? There is enough skill he have? No, then we need to provide the on the job training, how to make this product, how to make this process as per SOP. Sir, in my company everybody have the enough skill. We have the SOP, the people aware about that SOP, and we have the enough skill, but still there is a mistake happening. Now we come to the third question. Did he, she intended to follow the SOP? Okay. No, then we need to give the motivation. Sir, everything is there, sir. Still there is a error chance. Then we need to apply here the concept. We need to apply here the concept of human error principles. But in most of the Indian companies, the question start from here. First question will be whether you have the proper standard for this process or not. I hope we need to add one more checkpoint here. Then we need to go for others. Okay, the third misunderstanding, can multi-fold inspection can able to prevent the errors? Okay, so let's see, there is a different inspection stages. So single inspector, double inspectors, triple inspectors, 3-4 and 4-4, 5-4, like this. The first inspector, okay, error reduction rate is 65%, that means 0.35% there is a chance of missing. Okay, so with this theoretical calculation, we calculate like this, 1 minus 0.35 per 5. So when there is a 5 inspectors, if you are making continuously based on this person's performance, it should be 0.99. okay, so almost every error rate we can able to catch. But what actually saying, if you are putting more inspectors, still there is a different in capturing the errors. So this is what a real scenario. If you are adding more inspectors, it is not going to solve the root cause of error generation. Okay. Which line is bigger, whether A or B? Some people confuse A up to what, from here to here, or B up to what line? So what is the end of the A? What is the end of the B? So it is not clear. If I give like this, some extent we get a clearance. Okay, the both unstable and consciousness and error prone work operation come together and lead to the human errors. Okay, let me take one case study. Okay, one operator need to apply the heated resin in both the side of product. One operator need to apply the heated resin in both the side of the product. But unfortunately, he forgot to apply in one side. Okay, he forgot to apply in one side. What we generally will do? So error prevention campaign, additional inspector for checking. Okay, but still there is a reoccurrence of errors. Whatever be done, our effort, but still there is a reoccurrence of errors. Okay, so what is the observations from the operators? So these are the process steps. The first one, take the product from the line, apply the heated resin in the one side of the product, cool the product down for the offline. So one side, once the resin is applied, it need to cool for some time. Pick the product up and apply the resin in the another side, cool the product, put the product back to the line. So this is the process. Okay, here if we make it into color coding, so there is a color coding. Okay, there is a first resin color in orange. The another side, if you are making to white, what happened? There is a difference. So cooling. So first time operator using orange color pattern. Okay, and the second side, once the cooling is done, he take back, apply, and keep it into the white color cooling panel. So if you are making some differentiation of color, so it will make operator give enough awareness to the operator, you are doing correct. So immediately operator can able to differentiate and he can able to avoid the errors. So error proofing, there is a different names. So foolproof, okay, mistake proofing, error proofing, etc. Okay, so ultimate in this concept, what is the very important thing? Improve the human beings to fit the operations. So from here, we are moving to improve the operation to fit the human beings. We cannot change every human beings. Okay, so we need to set our operations to comfortable for all human beings. For example, when you are selecting operators, all operators having different height. Okay, you cannot able to select the operator only particular height people only required, then that person have the skill. So you make your workstation is more flexible. So you are improving the operation to fit the human beings. So we are coming to this point from here to here. So that is the ultimate aim of the HEP principles. Okay, let me go to the HEP principles, human error proofing principles. So this is what we learned from Mr. Takeshi Nagasho. Okay, these are the five major principles. Okay, let me come to the operations. What are the operations? So whenever we are doing tasks, and there is a risk also in this, and there is some function we are going to do, for that some memory, some perception, some motion is required, and process is happening. When there is a process, that area we are making the mistakes or errors. Okay, that errors give this abnormalities, and that abnormality going to give the bad impact effects. So accordingly, he made that major principles. There are five major principles. Okay, one is elimination. We can eliminate the task or we can eliminate the risk. Replacement, we can able to replace that, replace the human operation with the more reliable machines. There is some alternative solutions. Facilitation, to provide, make operation easier to perform. So I'm going to make something which will helpful to operator to make de-skilling or easy to perform. Okay, here detection, some abnormality happen, immediately we need to detect, then only we can able to separate from the good product. And final one is effects. Some bad impact is going to come. So that time, how we are going to avoid the mitigation? Okay, we are going to put that mitigation to avoid this bad effect. So these are the major principles. Okay. Now, the first one is elimination. So what elimination principle says, remove the work susceptible to human error from the process. Let me take this example. Okay. So there is one heavyweight product. We want to take this product with the help of metal wire. Okay. The metal wire, rope wire. Okay. It get cut due to sharp corners. To avoiding that, we need to involve battens. We need to involve battens. Okay. Sometime what happened? In this task, what is the additional task we are doing? There is an additional task. We need to place these battens before using the metal wires. Now, in this particular work, I am eliminating the task. What is the task? I need to put that batten. I am eliminating this entire work. Now, I am using the nylon belt to tilt this process. This is one small example. Okay, let me see. Elimination principle, task. What are the tasks? So normally, what are the tasks we do in operations? Mix or assemble, set the conditions, okay? Move from one area to another area, hand off, fill in, verify or adjust. Okay, these are the tasks. And whenever we are doing tasks, there is some equal risk also there, okay? Based on this principle, we are going to eliminate the task or eliminate the risk. Let me see one example. Okay, we already seen that moving metal part. Here we are using the eliminating the task of using that battens. Now, one example for eliminating the risk. Eliminate the risk. Okay, so here the example is touching a high temperature pipe. Okay, there is one pipe with going high temperature fluid is crossing this pipe. If you touch, then it will create an injury. So there is a risk. How we can able to eliminate the risk? By providing the proper insulation. We are providing the proper insulation to the pipe. So that eliminate the risk. So this is what elimination principle. We are eliminating tasks. We are eliminating the risk to avoid these mistakes, errors. In many cases, process equipment design must be changed drastically. So elimination solution have a great side effect on cost, productivity, and performance. This side effect must be considered. So whenever we want to do insulation, there is a cost involved. Okay. So we need to consider this. And replacement, this is the second principle, second major principle. Okay. Replace the human operation with the more reliable machines. Okay, for example, this is a particular shape. We need to sense. The operator need to sense accordingly. He need to take the where he need to keep the product. From here, based on the shape, operator need to take and he need to put into the particular tray, a particular storing location. Instead of that, if you are providing some limit switch, okay, with some lights. Where exactly, based on the shape, where exactly we need to keep. Okay, we are replacing that human no need to memory that which particular shape, where we need to keep like this. Instead of that, we are replacing the system, that system going to change. Okay, the system going to change that you know, boss, you know, need memory everything. So I'm just giving indication you accordingly you want. Okay, so this is what we are doing in a replacement principle. So replacement means here what we are replacing, one is memory, one is perception, another one is motion. So these are the three things we are replacing. So in operator no need to memory the things. Just assume as per most Maynard operation sequence technique, there is a 17 digit part number. If you want to read in a purchase order, that also work. Okay. And in front of machine, there are so many gauges available in operator. Operator need to take care of all the gauges, whether everything in within that limit, within the minimum maximum limit it is working. So operator cannot able to remember all these setting parameters. Okay. So instead of that, what we can do, there is one small Kaizen we are giving that color codes, green color, red color, yellow color, like this, we are giving the color codes. But still, operator need to monitor all these gauges. And all these gauges is not in front of machine, okay? Yeah, all these things located in different side of the machine. So how we are expecting from operator, operator need to work from one side, and at the same time, he need to take care of all the gauges. It is somewhat difficult, correct? So that's why we are creating one more principle called cockpit. Most of the companies using that principle, cockpit. In an aeroplane, where the pilot is controlling that flight, okay? So all this controlling parameter and monitoring parameter is in front of him. That area is called cockpit, okay? So he can control and monitor everything within his eyes and within his hands, reach of hands. So he can able to do this job in a better way. So same thing we want to give to operators. All these controlling parameters and measuring parameters will make in front of operators like a small cockpit. That will further reduce. But still, instead of memory, we are going to give some digital trigger. Second one is perception. Perception means here operator skill is not required. Here how without skill, by sensing something, he triggers that whether this particular work is completed or not. Let's assume there is a whiteboard marker. We need to close this whiteboard marker with the cap. When we place the clap, after some particular click, we are getting some click sound. So after this click sound, it indicates, okay, the cap is properly closed. So we are hearing the click sound and make sure that cap is properly closed. That is a perception. So here no skill is required, but with that sense, we are understanding, assuming that, yes, this work is done. So that is the perception. So motion here is to give support to tools such as checklist or reminders, guidelines, okay, to move here and there. Okay, for example, let us see they are forgetting to do the part of operation. Use the table showing the sequence. There is a route sheet. What should be the first operation? What should be second operation? So like this. So replacement here, the various methods can be considered depending on the number of functions that are replaced. So some of the function we cannot able to replace. It may be too costly. Some of the functions very, very important because it's only high field basis work, very critical work. That is a first priority we need to give for replacement. To replace all the function lead to large scale of unrealistic solutions. Okay. So we need to go in a step-by-step way, and it is there is a cost involvement also. It is essential to focus on error-prone functions. Okay. First, in which operation there is a more errors are happening, that particular operation we need to consider for the as a first priority. Okay, third principle is a facilitation to make the operation easier for workers to perform. We are providing a better environment or better work system so operator can able to perform in a very quickly. So here there is a three sub principles. One is simplification, distinction, or adjustment. Let's assume when you are going to deposit some money in a bank, okay, physically you are going, and there is some challan for deposit the money. The challan, they mention account number. You need to mention the account number. Let's assume there is a 16 digit account number. Sometime what happened, you are forget one digit or two digit. There may be a chance. Okay. So instead of that, if they clearly mention that is 16 digit boxes, how the pin code in our old letters, okay, letters, how they have the six boxes for pin code, that makes sure, yes, I need to fill all six digits. So makes the process more simplified, so we can able to reduce the errors. So what are things we can able to facilitate? Again, here we are facilitate for memory, so we are going to simplify things. Perception, we are going to distinction. For motion, we are doing the adjustment. Okay, these are the examples for simplification, selecting the wrong part. So here we are going to provide some markings. Okay, some of the people are still not muted. Please mute your audio, so that will be give good benefit to others. Okay. So facilitation, each solution has limited effectiveness. but it is cost and side effect or operations are minimal. Okay, so here facilitation is a whenever you are doing facilitation related kaizens or facilitation related projects, it will be a minimum cost. So do not use one method alone, but apply many methods together. Not only one method, we need to use the different methods. Okay, and list as many solutions idea possible, evaluate them. For example, let me take one check leaf. You are giving money to some of your clients or some of your suppliers, whoever, you are giving one check leaf. One check leaf contains how many data? What are things he have to fill? Okay, where exactly you need to sign? Okay, so sometime what happened, most of the times because of signature mismatch, most of the check get cancelled or there is some delay in this thing. So they are providing some box. Within the box, you need to put your signature. So that are things makes our work easy, simplification. Okay, that is a part of facilitation principle. Now detection, we are coming to the second part. Second part means now error is happened. Whatever the first three principles before errors, now this error is happened. Okay, now our principle is detection. Ensure that abnormalities caused by human error are detected and suitable corrective action is taken. Okay, let's assume this. This is one of the assembly line example. Assembly line, there is a ABC, three fasteners need to assemble. Okay, operator took the A from here. Okay, then operator need to take a B from here. Okay, operator skip this operation. Operator directly taking C from here. Then there is a limit switch connected in this particular tray. It will give a signal to that nut runner will not run. So if the operator is not taking from the right box, then the communication gives to the nut runner, don't do that. So operator here done the mistake. What is the error happening here? Wrong product he taken. That is the error happened. What is the detection method? So it is detected something operator did wrong, and it will give that signal to the assembly tool. The assembly tool will not run. Okay, here there is a detection. So what are the sub principles? One is record and verify the motion and indicate abnormality. So record and verify the motion to indicate the abnormality. The same examples. So whatever we are seeing from the last. So restrict the motions. So let the person notice the abnormality. We cannot able to, for example, pull push. Sometime what happen if both door is working from both the side, it will create error. Okay. Sometime without seeing that the person is standing on another side, the person is push the door, it will create an injury. But restrict the motion. Only one side is the pull or push. So that will create some awareness and that will reduce the error chance. Okay. And verify the result and indicate the abnormality. So misreading and report order and selecting the wrong part. So sensing the shape, providing some sensors that will going to reduce the impact, reduce the error. So late detection means large correction cost. Okay, if you are if you take more time, more process, we are not skipped that errors, and last stage only if you are finding that list mistakes, then it is a huge cost. Okay, so establish the techniques. Whenever there is an error happening, immediately we need to capture and we need to detect. And hardware has an important role. So prevent the hardware failure also. Errors are not prevented. Apply the prevention of occurrence solutions at the same time. So these are the major things we are focusing on detection. Last one, mitigation. Mitigate the effects of error by incorporating functional redundancies or using the shock absorbing materials. Okay, so let us assume that the in a shop floor, in particular cell, there is so many machines. Okay, in particular cell, one shop floor having the five cells. Okay, in each cell there is a different machines, and each machines was operated by individual operators. So what that individual operator need to do when the shift is end, the factory is about to close, that time he need to off the individual equipments properly. He need to do the J-gauge and properly he need to close the machines and place for everything place, then he need to power off the machine. In case even one operator forget in one particular machine, there is another responsibility. This is the responsibility of individual operator to the individual machine. And there is a certain responsibility assigned to the foreman. What he need to do, who is in charge for that particular entire cell, he will switch off that entire cell or to the entire cell. Same way, the entire shop floor, who is in charge for that entire shift, he will do the power off for the entire shop floor. So like this, there is some responsibility given to the individuals. So that will mitigate the effort. So if this person forget, this person will love. So that will take care. Even this person will forget, there is another person. So like, there is a roles and responsibility given like this to mitigate the impact, to mitigate the bad impact. The first one is there is a three sub-principles, redundancy. Okay, so now we whatever we see in example that is relevant to that. Fail-safe. Fail-safe means let us assume in our residency we have a home, we have so many costly electronic things, okay, like electrical things, electronic things, TV, computer, refrigerator, AC, so many things we have, okay. For protecting that, what we are using, that MCB, fail safe system we have. So whenever there is a high voltage fluctuation, high or low voltage fluctuation, suddenly what happened, instead of affecting our costly things, only this fail safe fuse will get affected. So we can able to simply replace that fuse with a minimum cost. So that is a fail safe system. Even our pressure cooker, we have that safety valves. Okay, instead of making that entire blast or some big impact, that 10 rupees safety valve will get a fuse, so we can able to save this. Okay, then another one, there is a protector. Make unsafe conditions not produce the losses. Okay, make unsafe condition not produce the losses. So knocking the product against the poles when putting them on shelves. So cover the poles with the shock absorbing material. So when you are putting the shock absorbing material, so that will save from that damage. So these are the of mitigation. So it is important to prevent the undesired effort. Okay, sometime what happened, there error is happened, we need to detect the error. Yes, at same time there is, it should not create some big bad impact. So we need to reduce this undesired effort by doing this mitigation. Focus on the chain of effects which leads to the undesired effects. So occurrence of error is not record, apply the detection solution at the same time. So this is a single slide consists of error proofing principle. These are the five major principles. The first three is before error is happening, so prevention of errors, and after once error has happened, minimize the effects. So that is a detection and mitigation. So these are the sub principles. These are the sub principles. So I go back to that particular main slide. I'll come back again. Okay, here you can see that percentage. That is some different percentage. What does this means? This is based on his experience, based on his research. Whenever he applying this different type of human error principle in a different industries, if 100%, whenever they are doing 100 projects, normally in one particular company, let assume if you did 100 projects and 5% go to this task elimination or risk elimination, 27% relevant to the replacement principle, 23% relevant to the facilitation principle, 40% relevant to the detection principle, and 5% reduction to the mitigation principle. It is based on his research, okay? Professor Takeshi Nakaso's research. So these are the five major principles and 13 sub-principles. So what is the approach to identify the improvement or opportunities? Okay, generate a solution and evaluating the solutions. So this is the checklist. Okay, so whenever we want to capture the human errors, first we need to give that observation. The major investment for any project is observation. Instead of money, we need to spend more time in the shop floor. So what I learned from my gurus, always I keep three things in my mind. So we need to come out of 3C. We need to come out of 3C. First C is AC. Come out of AC room. Don't spend your time in the meetings in the AC room. We need to go to the where exactly problem happening. That area only we can able to find a solution. Where you lost the key, that area only you need to search for a key. You are searching in a meeting room, you no use, you cannot able to search, you cannot able to get that. Okay, so first is see, switch off the AC. Second is see, don't spend more time on PC. Okay, computers, don't spend more time. Instead of that, go to that physical product where the process, time study, discuss with the operators, brainstorm karo. Then we need to do this. That third C is CC, sending so many email to CC. Okay, instead of that, go to the Gemba, same thing. So switch off the AC, don't use much PC, don't send more mail to CC. AC, PC, CC. Avoid this, go to the Gemba, spend more time on observation. Observe the process. Discuss with the operators. Sometimes operator have good ideas. So we need to ask these questions. Eliminate. Can we eliminate this particular error prone process? Can we eliminate the harmful error? So like this, we need to discuss. When we are discussing provoking questions, we are getting better solutions. So we need to write. So based on each why, what is the final why, we need to ask the questions. We need to provide the solutions. And we need to give the special solution priority number. So we need to give the rating for each solution. As a team, we need to give the rating. So for this idea, how much it is affecting us? For this idea, how much is the cost impact area? If it is a high cost, low marks. It is a low cost, high marks. So implementation, it is easy to implement. Is it within our team control? Then accordingly, there is a mark. So the multiplying this thing is SPA number, so solution priority number. Okay. So normally we'll give number 1, 2, 3. My idea is mostly we'll give 3, 6, 9. So we can find a better difference. Okay. So this is a flow chart. There is a defect happening. So we need to do that LO analysis, process conformity analysis. Okay. Is there a defect because of human errors? We need to follow this. Okay. Human error checklist. Different possible solutions need to create, analyze the solutions, action plan, implement the solutions, and check the effectiveness. If effectiveness is good, problem is closer. If effectiveness is not good, then reoccurrence, redo, PDCA. The most important thing is the employee involvement. So it's not like a cinema, one person can able to do, one man army, nothing is possible. So more important is the operators, the person who make the mistakes, he can able to give the solutions, because he will tell because of why he is making mistake, what is the uncomfortable. So if you attack the uncomfortable, everything will be easier. Okay, so this is the employee involvement, train the operators, understanding the theory, take one problem from daily work, put the problem into human error prevention checklist, generate the solutions, evaluate that solution priority number, select the solution for implementation, implement the solution and monitor the effectiveness. Okay. So apply this in a QC circle. You create a QC circle, train them,